warriors. In this video, I will discuss the differences between type 1 and type 2 diabetes. So you're probably wondering, why should we discuss the differences between the two? Because knowledge is power. The more we know, the less likely toddlers, kids, adults are going to be misdiagnosed. The more we know, the more awareness that gets spread towards finding a cure. Insulin is not a cure. Not only that, but we need to make the public eye aware that insulin access is important and insulin should be affordable for all. Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune disease. I have type 1 diabetes and my pancreas no longer produces insulin. It wasn't preventable, it just happened one day. I got really sick, thirsty, lost a bunch of weight, and I was really tired all the time. Basically, what happened is my immune system attacked the cells in my pancreas thinking that they were invaders. Our bodies are incredible, but with an autoimmune disease, something just goes wrong and there's nothing you could do about it. Now I have to inject myself with insulin several times a day in order to stay alive. If my body doesn't have adequate amount of insulin, my blood sugar gets really high and my blood becomes toxic and it can be really deadly. My body needs insulin to absorb the energy I intake from food and disperse it throughout my body. Type 1 diabetes is not curable. I will have it for the rest of my life or until scientists find a cure. Type 2 diabetes is where the body doesn't produce enough insulin or becomes resistant to it. The condition can sometimes be controlled with proper diet and exercise, or a drug you usually see on TV to enhance the sensitivity to the body's insulin production. But sometimes natural insulin production is still insufficient and insulin injections are needed in type 2 diabetics. So, what causes diabetes? In type 1 diabetes, researchers believe that a genetic component is actually passed down and it's triggered by an illness, trauma, or stress, but there's no definite cause. For instance, I'm the only one in my family who has type 1 diabetes. Research data is always changing and there's so many trials being done to gain a better picture. In type 2 diabetes, there is a risk factor, including obesity, family history, and lifestyle habits. In some cases, there is room to improve this condition with proper diet and exercising. But the huge misconception surrounding this illness is that sugar causes diabetes. Sugar does not cause diabetes. Even with type 2 diabetes, some people are just more susceptible to it and their bodies just slowly stop producing enough insulin. Now, I want to point out that I am not a medical professional. I'm not a doctor. I just live with type 1 diabetes. If you or someone you know has questionable symptoms, please seek medical attention right away. Just one finger stick that takes literally 2 seconds can save a life. Another point I'd like to make is you are your own advocate. If the doctor says, oh, it's probably the flu, an ear infection, a stomach bug, still demand a test. Always, always rule out diabetes. It's not a big test and it doesn't take a lot of time, but it's life-saving. Here are symptoms to be aware of that apply to both type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Extreme thirst, frequent urination, fruity odor on breath, drowsy or lethargic, sudden rapid weight loss, vision becomes blurry, mood changes, stomach pain, nausea, vomiting. Also, if you have diabetes and need some support, I've left links below to join my Facebook page, Instagram, or Facebook group, which provides a lot of support. All right, that about wraps it up for today. Please leave me a comment or question or a topic that you'd like me to discuss next time. Bye, guys.